YouTube, welcome back. It's your boy Clutch. We're here for another reaction. It's your guy Machine Gun Kelly. He's coming with a song, Lonely. We're strolling right through old Tickets to My Downfall, man. I really enjoy every bit of this album. I've had nothing but good things to say about every song that I've heard, so I don't expect it to get any worse now. So, let's sit back and see what Mr. Machine Gun says.
I got in trouble the first time my dad saw me dance with the devil. How are we so opposite? I lived with your sister, my first home since mom had left.
Okay, so it sounds like he's getting kind of personal. Like right off the rip, he's talking about, says your sister, which makes me believe that it's his dad because he speaks a ton about his aunt. So, actually, I think he said something about his dad right there at the beginning. Sorry, but yeah, nonetheless, I'm pretty sure he's speaking about his dad and his aunt, which I believe both have passed at this point.
I wrote my first song with him in the basement. And then he said goodbye way too soon.
That's deep, man. That's exactly what he's talking about. He's talking about his aunt and his dad. Probably more specifically so, his dad at this moment in time. And he says that no matter what, he'd trade it all just to have him back. Because he's always lonely inside. Which is an interesting take from somebody who really never knew his dad. And also did not know his mother. So, interesting to see where, as an adult, where he's at and how he feels about those people. Yeah, so Cobb saw him dance with the devil. He called his sister. It's definitely talking about his dad and his aunt.
She cried when she picked me up. Goddamn, now I miss her. Cause she didn't give a fuck. And then she said goodbye. Way too soon. This don't feel right without you.
It's a deep song, man. I'm happy to see him express himself, though. Like, let it out, brother. It's okay. It's okay to be upset, especially over a death. Nobody can tell you how to mourn or how to feel after certain situations. So I'm happy to see that he's just kind of laying it all out there. And like, this is coming from somebody who didn't even have these people growing up. Well, I mean, I guess he had his aunt, but like I'm saying, like in the sense of his dad that he was speaking of, it's like, dude, he was never even there. And even now, like, you lose him now and it still makes you feel lonely. So it's like, it just really further proves the point. Like, you only get one mom, one dad. Like, that's it. And like, no matter whether you speak to him for 30 years or not, it still hurts when you realize you're never going to get to say anything again.
The last time I saw you, fuck. I cried, I wish you had more time left. The last time I heard you, they held the phone, you took your last breath.
I believe that's how his aunt passed. I'm almost fairly certain that he was not around when his aunt had passed, and he had called her and she passed.
The last time I saw you, I cried, I wish you had more time left. The last time I heard you,
play that part like all as one, so we're just gonna hit a stop right there. And I'll say, man, it's a deep song, man. I feel for you, brother. I've never lost nothing that close to me, but I still feel I know what you're saying. Let's let that play out. I love it. I love it. I love listening to him sing. I don't even expect the best from him. I never do. I don't expect him to be the best singer in the world, but do you, man. Fit what fits you. Sing where you belong to sing. Write music where you fit in to write. And I feel like this fits him perfect.
His umbilical cord was stuck around his neck.
Oh my God. So I'm assuming this is his father and him. At least his father. I'm going to assume it's who's talking right now. And if you didn't hear what they said that it was a hard birth and the umbilical cord was wrapped around his neck. I'm going to assume they're speaking of Kells, but let's see.
So I ended up undoing the umbilical cord. And he was bigger than the normal child. I don't know what it was, but he had a heart problem and they didn't think he would live.
Oh, Jesus. He had a heart problem and they didn't think he'd live. Ignore all this fucking shenanigans over here, man. I hate when the stuff just magically goes right into the next video. But, thank you guys. Let me get this off my screen. There, that's what needs to be here. Thank you guys for checking out my video and all my goofy shenanigan bullshit that I deal with. But anyway, if you like the video, like the video. If you enjoy me and you want to see me do more of these, subscribe to the channel. And you know what? You should share it. You should share it with your mom, your dog, your cat, your sister, her friends' friends, and those friends' friends' friends. And keep sharing it then. Until next time, YouTube. Peace.